नमस्कार दोस्तों, आज के इस वीडियो में हम क्लास 9th की मैथमेटिक्स में सरफेस एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम चैप्टर पर चर्चा करने वाले हैं। तो आइए हमारे इस वीडियो का आनंद उठाइए और अपने ज्ञान को बढ़ाइए। तो इस वीडियो में हम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट पर चर्चा करने वाले हैं, सरफेस एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम से आप क्या समझते हैं और इसके विषय में क्या बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स हैं। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो एंड एंजॉय इट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सॉलिड्स? द बॉडीज ऑक्यूपाइंग स्पेस आर कॉल्ड सॉलिड्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, क्यूबॉइड, क्यूब, सिलेंडर, कॉन, दीज ऑल आर थ्री डायमेंशनल ऑब्जेक्ट आर कॉल्ड सॉलिड्स। सरफेस एरिया मीन्स, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाई सरफेस एरिया? एन अमाउंट ऑफ रीजन ऑक्यूपाइड बाई द सॉलिड इज कॉल्ड सरफेस एरिया। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग, यू आर सीइंग दीज ऑब्जेक्ट, जस्ट दीज आर सिलेंडर एंड यू कैन सी दैट दिस ग्रीन पार्ट विच यू सीन इन योर आईज अराउंड दिस सिलेंडर is known as surface area. For the second one, this is also blue part which you seen, that is a surface area. After that, here is you can see that the top part and this in front part, this is also known as surface area. After that, what do you mean by volumes? An amount of space occupied by the solid is called surface area. For example, in the same things, here you can see that the interior region of this cylinder, इस cylinder के अंदर के part को हम volume कहते हैं। Second में देखें अगर, तो ये दूसरा cylinder है, इस cylinder में क्या हम fill कर सकते हैं, उस रीजन को, उस स्पेस को हम कहते हैं वॉल्यूम। सेकंड थर्ड वन में अगर देखें तो ये जो थर्ड सिलेंडर आपका रेड कलर है, उसके अंदर कितना स्पेस है, उस स्पेस को ही हम वॉल्यूम कहते हैं। तो सरफेस एरिया और वॉल्यूम में इतना ही डिफरेंस है। सरफेस का मतलब जो बाहर का पार्ट है जिसे आप देख सकते हैं, वो आपका सरफेस एरिया होता है, और वॉल्यूम का मतलब इस ऑब्जेक्ट के अंदर कितना स्पेस है उसे हम वॉल्यूम कहते हैं। सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट सॉलिड इज क्यूबॉइड एंड यू कैन सी दैट दिस क्यूबॉइड हैज 6 फेसेस एंड 8 वर्टिसेस, आफ्टर दैट 12 एजेस। सो if the length of the cuboid is L and breadth is B and the height is H, then the first formula for the cuboid is lateral surface area of cuboid 2 into under bracket L plus B into H. Similarly, here is the second same formula for area of four walls of a room, that is 2 into L plus B into H. So keep in your mind that these two things are same, means lateral surface area of the room and the area of four walls of the room, this is the same things. After that, surface area of the cuboid, that is 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. And then total surface area of the cuboid is also same to same, that is 2 into LB plus BH plus HL, means total surface area and the surface area of the cuboid will be same. and after that volume of cuboid, that is L into V into H, and then length of the diagonals of cuboid, that is, this is the formula, under root L square plus B square plus H square. So you can find the diagonals, that is the length of diagonal of cuboid by this formula. After that, second object is a cube. So if side of cube is A, then you can see that here is the lateral surface area of cube, that is 4A square, and surface area of cube, that is 6A square, and after that total surface area of cube is also 6A square. Means surface area and total surface area of cube is same things. After that, volume of cube, that is side cube, and it is A cube. If A is the side of this cube, then the volume of cube is A cube. And after that, length of diagonals of cube, this is A under root 3. This is the formula to find the length of the diagonals of A cube, that is A into under root 3, where A is the side of cube. So this is the cube which has all sides are equal, and also it has 12 edges and 8 vertices, and after that 6 faces. All faces are square and all sides are equal. Now moving for next solid, that is cylinder. So here is the first formula, that is lateral surface area of cylinder 2 pi r h, where r is the radius of the cylinder and h is the height of cylinder. So now curved surface area, that is CSA of cylinder. Why it is curved surface area? Because cylinder is made by the curve, not a straight line, that is edges. So here we will take curved surface area in the place of surface area or total surface area. So here we will take the curved surface area for the cylinder. This is also same 2 pi r h. After that, total curved surface area, that is TSA of cylinder, is 2 pi r h plus pi r square. Means if you add the area of both base, that is top and the base, that is pi r square plus pi r square, means this is circular part. So you will get the total surface area, that is 2 pi r, it is the curved surface area, and plus 2 pi r square, this is the base area of both part, top and bottom. Then you will get it is 2 pi r plus h. This is the total curved surface area of the cylinder. Now volume of cylinder is pi r square h. So keep in your mind what is the volume, pi r square h. Now the base area of the cylinder, keep in mind, that is pi r square, because always base is just in the form of circular form. Now circumference of the cylinder, this is 2 pi r. You can see that this is the cylinder. It has top part and base part having the radius r and the perpendicular height, that is h. So this top part having the circular part, area of this circular part is pi r square, and the base part is also circular part, so the area of this base part is pi r pi r square. So pi r square and pi r square means 2 pi r square, and the other area, that is curved surface area of the cylinder, is 2 pi r f. So total surface area you can find adding these three things, that is 2 pi r and r plus h. Now you can move for next. This is top and base, two parts. Now moving for next solid, that is cone. So here if you take, this is the shape of cone, this is the new solid, and in this comb. You can see that top part is known as vertex, and this red dotted line, that is the perpendicular distance, is known as height of the cone, and this base dotted line is known as the radius from the center, that is R, and this height, that is, you can see here, that is slant height of the cone indicated by the symbol L, and the height is indicated by the symbol H, and radius you know well, that is R. So here's the first formula for the cone is lateral surface area of the cone is pi RL, and then curved surface area of the cone is pi RL. After that, the total curved surface area of the cone is pi RL plus base area, that is pi R square. You will get it, pi R R plus L. You can see here very clearly, this top part is the curved surface area, and this is the bottom part is circular form. Therefore, area of circle is pi R square. So you will get the total surface area, pi R L plus pi R square, that is pi R under bracket R plus L. This is the total curved surface area of the cylinder. So it is known as TSA. Now the volume of cylinder, this is 1/3 of volume of cone. This is 1/3 of the volume of cylinder, because volume of cylinder is pi R square. So the volume of cone is 1/3 pi R square H. After that, moving for next, base area of the cone pi R square, and then circumference of the cone is same, that is 2 pi r. Now here is one thing is remaining, that is a slant height. How can you find the value of L? So L is written as under root r square plus h square. This is the slant height, means L equal to under root r square plus h square. So this is known as slant height. You can find either things of three things there, R, H or L. If two things is given, so you can find the other remaining things. So this is the next one is solid cone. Now moving forward, this is, you can see that this is the base area, which is indicated by the arrow. So this is circular part. This circular part means area of this circular part is always pi R square, and the circumference of circular part is 2 pi R. Okay, now moving for next solid, that is sphere. And you can see here, this is the diagram for sphere, and sphere, this is the most probably example for cricket ball. So cricket ball, this is just form of a sphere. And then in this sphere, you can see that there is the radius of sphere is R, because this is three dimensional things object. So here is length is, that is R, and height is also R, and the breadth is always R, means length, breadth and height, all things are same, that is just equal to the radius. So now here is the first formula, that is lateral surface area of the sphere. It is 4 pi r square, and then the curved surface area of the sphere, that is again this is same things, 4 pi r square, and you will get another things are also same, that is total curved surface area of the sphere, that is 4 pi r square, means all three things are just equal, that is 4 pi r square. Now the volume of sphere is 4/3 pi r cube. Keep in mind that what is the formula to find the volume of sphere, that is 4/3 pi r cube, where r is the radius of the sphere. Now moving for the next object, that is solid, is hemisphere. You can see that this is the picture, this is the figure of 3D shapes, that is hemisphere. In this hemisphere, you can see that there are two things. One thing, that is surface area, which you see in the blue part, and the white part, this is the circular region. So this is known as the second part. So how can you find the curved surface area and total surface area of this hemisphere if the radius of hemisphere is R? So here is the first formula, that is lateral surface area of the hemisphere. This is 2 pi R square, means this 2 pi R square you can got just half of the curved surface area or total surface area or lateral surface area of sphere. अगर आप स्फीयर के फॉर्मूले को हाफ कर दें, 4 पाई आर स्क्वायर को हाफ कर लेंगे, तो आपको 2 पाई आर स्क्वायर मींस हेमिस्फीयर का लेटरल सरफेस एरिया मिल जाएगा. नाउ कर्व सरफेस एरिया ऑफ हेमिस्फीयर, दिस इज सेम थिंग्स, यू विल गेट 2 पाई आर स्क्वायर, जस्ट हाफ ऑफ द स्फीयर. नाउ मूविंग फॉर नेक्स्ट, टोटल सरफेस एरिया, टोटल कर्व सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द हेमिस्फीयर, कीप इन माइंड दैट दिस इज 3 पाई आर स्क्वायर. This is the most important things. Why? Because curved surface area, this is blue part region in the figure. You can see that in this figure, this blue part is the curved surface area. That is 2 pi r square. And the white part just in the circular region. So area of this circular region is pi r square. And pi r square plus 2 pi r square, that is 3 pi r square. So the total curved surface area of the hemisphere is 3 pi r square. Now the volume of hemisphere, just half of the hemisphere of, just half of the volume of sphere. The volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r square. So the half of 4 by 3 pi r square, this is 2 by 3 pi r cube. Sorry, the volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. And the volume of hemisphere, just half of the volume of sphere, that is 2 pi 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so now this is, you can see that this is circular part, and here is the circumference of circular part is always 2 pi r, and the area of the circular part is pi r square. Okay, now dear, so now about units, what are you write the units in the case of surface area and in the case of the volume. So always you write the units in the case of surface area, that is square units, and in the place of units you can write meter, centimeter, kilometer, hectometer, decameter, decimeter, etc. So you can write in the case of area, that is square centimeter, square kilometer, square meter, or in the second form you also can write that centimeter square, meter square, kilometer square, decimeter square, etc. Now for the units of volume, you can write is cubic units, and in the place of units you can write centimeter, millimeter, kilometer, hectometer, decameter, centimeter, etc. So for example, the cubic centimeter, cubic kilometer, cubic centimeter, or you can write it as centimeter cube, or meter cube, or kilometer cube, or hectometer cube, or decameter cube. Similarly, you can write the units of volume. This is just degree 3. And in the units for area, just degree 2. So dear, note, here is the most important point for you. Before solving the question, convert all the measurement in the same unit. किसी भी question का solution लिखने से पहले आप observe कीजिए कि क्या उस question में सभी units same ही दिए गए हैं. अगर same units नहीं दिए हैं तो सबसे पहले उन्हें आप सेम यूनिट में कन्वर्ट करेंगे, तभी आप उस क्वेश्चन का आंसर लिखना स्टार्ट करेंगे, नहीं तो आंसर आपके गलत आएंगे. तो यहाँ पे इस चीज को ध्यान रखना है, अगर यूनिट सेंटीमीटर में दिए हुए हैं तो सभी यूनिट्स सेंटीमीटर में ही होने चाहिए, और अगर मीटर में है तो सारे मेजरमेंट मीटर में ही होने चाहिए, और अगर किलोमीटर में यूनिट्स दिए हुए हैं तो सभी मेजरमेंट्स किलोमीटर में ही होने चाहिए. So dear, so thank you friends to watching my video up to last.
And don't forget to like, share and comment it. And subscribe my channel for getting first of all my video. Thank you once again.